Hey, YouTube family and podcast family. Today, I wanted to talk about something a viewer brought to my attention recently. She was talking about a friend that she finally broke off with 20 years, two decades later. And the thing is, she felt like she wasted so much of her time on this narcissistic friend. Now, I've had the same situation happen to me, and I kind of felt the same way as well. And a good friend of mine is going through the same thing, where she's breaking off a friendship that has turned out to reveal itself to be very narcissistically abusing, or had a lot of narcissistic abuse in it. So I wanted to talk about this today because we sometimes get pulled back into relationships because the narcissist wants to stay friends, or we may have friends who we were never romantic with, but they are continually draining us of life, and they're bitter or jealous, and we don't realize it at first because they also kind of cover it up with niceties, and they're pleasant, and they may do things for you. And you think, well, this is a friendship, right? There's give and take, and we contribute each to this friendship. But underlying all of it, you kind of sense that there's something just not right with this friendship. And a lot of times, what I think it is a jealousy that runs through the narcissist, is this undercurrent that the narcissist has in every relationship they have. They are jealous of their friend. They are jealous of what you have, and yet they want you to be in their life. And you're kind of confused because this person wants you in their life, and yet they kind of, you feel somewhat of an animosity from them. You kind of feel like they don't care. And yet sometimes they act like they do care. So you're still attached to them. You think, well, we're still part of this friend group, and we'll just, you know, continue to our relationship because, you know, we have a social circle that we are a part of. So it kind of feels like it's okay. And yet it's actually still robbing you of time, and you don't know that until it ends. And that's when you look back and you go, why was I friends with this person for two decades? Or in my case, a whole decade. And another one of my friends is going through this, and she's doing great, by the way. I mentioned her in a past video, when the narcissist is a jerk, why are we surprised, right? It takes gets to a certain point when we finally cannot take any more. And that's when we cut it off. And when we look back, we're like, this person was a part of my life for so many years, is in so many of my pictures, has been part of so many outings and trips and vacations and get-togethers. They've been there through some holidays. We've shared so much. And yet you look back and you think, you know, you feel like you're losing so many years. And yet what you don't realize is all that time that narcissistic friend was in your life, they were taking up space where a better friend should have been. And you may leave this friendship feeling a lot of regret and maybe even some resentment that they took up so much of your time. Now, I know this happens in romantic relationships, but I want to cover this in family relationships and friendships as well, because we do lose time. What we don't realize is they'd been cluttering our life all those years. And we might feel like, what the heck? I've been living in this mess for all those years. I've been pulled into their misery. I've been pulled into their drama. I've been pulled into their craziness that I did not have to deal with. I've, you know, gotten them out of all their messes. I've gone and fixed all their, you know, problems with them, sat through all these nights. I spent so many hours consoling them. I've spent so many days, you know, catering to their needs because they were always wounded. Or, oh my gosh, you know, you just feel like, you look back at your life and you're even though they had spent some good things with you, some good times with you, some holidays and things like that. But they probably also made a mess of those holidays. They've ruined a few of those times. They've ruined, you know, parts of that holiday. They've ruined parts of the vacation. They've ruined parts of every outing you've had. You know, it's just, and you think, oh my gosh, I'm carrying around all this clutter in my life, and they ruined my life, like this, so many years of my life. When I could have had something beautiful, they took up all this space. Well, you know, I want you to take a look at it like your cluttered closet. You know, you live in this cluttered closet, or you have a cluttered closet or a cluttered garage, and you've dealt with it for years and maybe even decades. And it doesn't feel good to have it, but it's too much work to clean out, and it's too much work to actually go through and do the work needed to make it nice. So you just live with it because it's okay. You know, it's okay for now. Well, that's kind of what the narcissist has been like in your life. They were okay for then, and you put up with it. And what you don't understand, though, is that during those years, they've actually been binding you, handcuffing you to misery, to their misery, right? And you keep putting up with it because you think it's okay for now, and it's just too much work to actually end this. It's too much work to actually fix what's broken inside of me in order to let go of them. It's too much work to try to change them anymore, because then when I try that, it makes the mess even worse, right? They make things even worse for you, more dramatic, and they pull you into more, you know, depression or guilt or manipulations, and you just don't want to deal with it. So you kind of live with the clutter that they have brought into your life. And like I said, it takes finally something that just opens your eyes to the point that you are bound, you are imprisoned, and you don't want it anymore. And you're like, I'm sick of this. I'm sick of living this way. I don't want this anymore. And you finally stop it. You finally cut them loose, right? You finally free yourself. Now that you're free, you start working on yourself, right? You start questioning, what was it about me that kept them around? Why did I need them? Why do I miss them? You know, what's wrong? You know, let me look back at my past and the clutter and the mess, you know, the debris in our path behind us, and see what I can sort out there and clean up and put away. And you still are going to feel kind of bound for a while. But it's okay, because you're starting the work. You're starting the work of cleaning up your life. You're starting to clean up your relationships, your friendships, your ties to other people. And this is what it looks like, okay, you guys? It's a picture of, I think this is an emergency vehicle, and they have all their tools and all their equipment in perfect spots, and everything is clean and it's orderly. Well, that's the only way an emergency technician can work, is if things are orderly. They can get to the tools they need when they need it, right? And the proper tools for the proper occasion. So whatever the emergency is, they know exactly where to go to get what they need to help the person. And we think, well, our life can't be like this, right? Because this is a professional. Only professionals can be this clean and this orderly. But no, we can too. This can be your life. This can be our life, where we put into order our mental health. We put into order our financial health. We put into order our emotional health. And when that happens, what you can do is, when a person comes into your life and they have certain needs, you know exactly where to go in your heart or in your mind to help them. But you don't give them the whole truck, right? You don't give them all of your tools. You don't give them all of you. You just give them what you know they need. Now, it's up to them to respond in a way that's healthy and that helps them. And if they don't, then you take them to the hospital and you let them deal with that person there, because it's beyond your help. But here's the thing. Your life can be this orderly. your life can be so uncluttered. And once you clean out that closet or that garage full of crap, right, you don't think, oh, look at my, you know, I can't believe I lived in such a mess for so long. Instead, you're like, wow, this is great. How clean everything is. This is amazing. I can see everything. I feel so free. I feel so much peace. When you look at a clean closet after you've gone through everything that's in there and you throw away all the stuff that doesn't fit anymore or that's torn or that you're like, what in the world is even back here? Once you clean out all of that, when you go back into your clean closet, you don't beat up yourself for having had a dirty closet or a messy closet for 2 or 3 years. You're just happy now that it's so clean, right? I've done this where I'll even go and sit in the closet once it's been cleaned out. And I'm like, wow, it's just so peaceful in here. It feels so good. There's no more, funny enough, emotional baggage that came along with the clutter that you saw inside of your closet. Same thing with a narcissistic friend. Once you get rid of them, sadly to say, once you cut them out of your life, you start to see like, wow, I have so much time. I'm not staying up to 2 in the morning trying to fix their problems anymore. I'm actually getting sleep now. I'm not running to their aid every other day or loaning them my car and then having to suffer and scrimp and save for my own self because I'm always bailing them out. Suddenly, it's like you have clarity and cleanliness, and people start coming into your life who bring you joy. And you're like, wow, this is great. It's not like I have to go visit this darkness all the time anymore. Now, suddenly, the world is brighter and more open. And the friendships you start to make, by the way, here's the thing. When you have a clean closet, you start to become more choosy about what you do put into that closet from that point on, because you remember how cluttered it got before. So same thing with friends. When you no longer have these narcissistic, toxic, horrible people, abusive people in your life, you start to be more choosy about what you put in your life, the people you allow to take up time in your life. You still help out people, but you don't let them take over the rooms in your heart anymore. You don't let them take over the rooms in your mind anymore and clutter it up to the point where you can't even function anymore. So you guys, I hope that this talk has helped you to put into perspective. When you cut out a narcissist in your life, it does feel bad sometimes, and you might linger for a while, and you might resent that you spent so many years, you know, with that clutter in your life. But remember, it's like a closet. Once it's clean, you're not going to think about all the clutter that you lived with for years and years. You're just going to embrace and enjoy the openness now, the freedom, the cleanliness, that you can breathe, you know, again. You're going to enjoy that. So you guys, if this has helped, please subscribe, please like, comment, and share this video. And I'm wishing you much love and health and joy and lots of wholeness. Blessings to you guys, and I'll talk to you soon.